Manhattan Garment District, New York City, USA. Zerkheizi, a former associate of Morgenholt, may be working with somebody known as Dvorak to gather classified intelligence about weaponized algorithms known as the mass kernels. Determine who Dvorak is and what his relationship is to Zerkheizi. Greetings, fellow earthlings. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, played in the tactical assault style. Now, as is obvious for this playthrough, we will not be being stealthy at all, except for where it is necessary. I mean, during the first portion of this mission, there are some members of the National Guard patrolling the streets that we need to get around, so I do believe it would be beneficial for us if we do not draw a weapon against them, but maybe we can go ahead and try, because, I do not aim to kill them, but at the same time, maybe we could shock them instead, you know, since this is, after all, a tactical assault playthrough. Let's see how it goes. Now, the story thus far is that Bruce Morgenholt, a computational theorist, who's working on the mass kernels, which are essentially information warfare-enabled software programs, was kidnapped by Hugo Lacerda, who was essentially contracted by Douglas Shetland of Displaced, but the NSA does not know it yet. Spoiler warning, like, this entire playthrough will contain spoilers for those of you who have not played this game yet. If you want to know what actually happens in this game, check out my two other playthroughs, which are, you know, the first one would be the Ghost playthrough, and the second one would be the Field Interrogator playthrough. So, at any rate, what the NSA is trying to figure out now is, how is Zerkheizi involved in all of this? They essentially found out who was bankrolling Lacerda, and from that connection, they made the connection that that Zerkheizi is somehow involved. So, the next obvious step is to investigate Zerkheizi's penthouse, especially considering the blackout that just hit New York City. Well, it hasn't hit yet, but it's going to hit in the cutscene right now. So, well, that's the thing. Shetland is essentially playing Zerkheizi for information about the mass kernels. Zerkheizi, he actually used Zerkheizi's help to build the Dvorak, which he uses to utilize the mass kernels for his own personal benefit. So, yeah, that's that. So with that being said, let's go ahead and look at the briefing then. Actually, rather, the cutscene.
So Zerkheizi and Morgenholt are the only two people who ever saw those algorithms.
And Morgenholt is dead. And Zerkheizi is connected to a mystery guest we know nothing about.
Dvorak.
Morgenholt and Zerkheizi are geeks, not terrorists. Maybe this Dvorak is some kind of puppeteer.
No hitter, bottom of the eighth.
2-0, New York in the eighth.
Hakeem Watanabe is on the mound. He's pure concentration, pure focus.
This is no coincidence. You're on your way to the Big Apple.
Bruce Morgenholt and Ibrahim Zerkheizi were partnered together on Project Watson, the UN committee that cracked the mass kernels. They're the ones who discovered 512 encryption, the same encryption used in the messages you recovered at MCAS Bank. If this so-called Dvorak person has somehow gotten his hands on mass-based IW algos, we're in a world.
Dvorak is a computer.
I've been trying to penetrate Zerkheizi's private network since we connected him to this mess. I've seen some tough network security before, and I expected Zerkheizi to have top-of-the-line tech, but this is crazy. Zerkheizi's server isn't just impenetrable or invisible, it's like looking for a shadow in a pitch-black room.
Yeah, how are you gonna look at something that's sort of internet-enabled?
Things are turning sour in New York. It's been 24 hours since the blackout, and no one has a clue when it might end. We've got sporadic reports of unrest all over Manhattan, but it hasn't started to spill over yet. Word coming down from above is that the National Guard will be deployed within the hour. We'll need to insert you into an alley behind a building adjacent to the target building. Watch out for civilians.
Well, there are none, but there are National Guard in this level, which is essentially what the biggest issue is. Now, the reason that Grim can't find the computer, can't find Dvorak, or rather, even the server is Dvorak, the first thing to get out of the way here. And the reason she can't find it is because it's a punch card machine. And those things did not have internet and the internet was not invented back then. So, yeah, good luck finding it. At any rate, let's go ahead and address the mission then. Now, here's what I'm a little concerned about. Should I take the SC20 key, or should I stick to Redding's recommendation? Because see, I'm getting like three sticky shockers right here, and I'm also getting like a sniper attachment to use along with flash and smoke grenades. So I think I might as well stick to Redding's recommendation, because well, I can actually eliminate people without killing them with this loadout. I do not have any A4 ring rounds though, which is sad. I think I'll only get that with the stealth loadout. Or maybe the assault? Yeah, three A4 ring rounds. But no. How do I put this? Sticky shockers. Choices, tough choices. I'd actually prefer, given the environment here in this level, I would rather prefer smokes and flashes and a sticky shocker over a airfall round. We can always use the sticky cam to just knock people out anyway. So yeah, let's go.
Fisher, the National Guard was deployed into Manhattan about an hour ago.
I feel safer already.
Watch your fire, Sam. Those boys aren't expecting to see you and they'll attack on sight. Do not, I repeat, do not kill any of them.
I'll be careful.
Good.
Now, should we just go ahead and use the sticky shockers now? Or should we try and use the sticky cameras instead? I'll wait for this guy to come back. I'm saving here because I want to try...
What the?
Nope. Okay. So here's the thing. I thought about it and I decided to go and just use... maybe the sticky shockers. I mean, I would rather preserve them, so since I can take this guy outside, they might as well do that. Go old school with this guy. Since these guys are wearing helmets, it's difficult to take them out using any kinds of shocking equipment. Sorry, the airfoil ring rounds. Sticky cam. Come on. And you're gonna move on, come on.
No one here. No signs of disturbance.
Well, except for you, you're gonna be disturbed in just a while here. This thing is in the way. I'm probably gonna get spotted if I decide to go there. I could wait for it to blow out, but maybe I could just take this path here. I could just knock this guy out as well, to be honest, but do I really want to? Choices. I thought about it and I decided, you know what, let's just go ahead and not disturb these people at all. Let's just do the stealthy way instead. Neat trick with the first person mod. If you have a weapon drawn, you can walk as fast as you want to without causing any sound.
Fisher, looks like the National Guard are trying to restore the power to the building's elevator. That's probably your best way to the top.
I'll see if I can hitch a ride.
It'll be a long climb if you don't.
Yeah, so right now my plan is just to go ahead and stay right here. Or maybe. Okay, the guy's right there. I'll wait for you to move first before I decide to make my own move. Yeah, I just wanted to come here and grab this flash.
What's the status on that elevator?
I'll have it running in a sec.
Well, speed it up. We need to get some more equipment up to the roof.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to wait for that guy to, you know, stop working and see how this level goes. Let me switch over to the sticky shocker because they removed that. It was probably a bug that we were exploiting in the previous games. We were hitting people in the head with a sticky cam, more or less knocked them out. I'm going to give these guys some time. And I'm gonna go check on the elevator as well. That's where the elevator is being repaired, by the way. Probably should not be saving as much. Looks like the elevator is done. Or not. Or not. Oh yeah, it is done. Cool. There should be a guy right here. Somewhere over here. I don't know where, but somewhere over yeah, right there. I'll save these three sticky shockers for when I actually head to the roof. I'm gonna need it once I'm there. At the roof, I mean. Get to Zerkheizi's penthouse and observe the meeting or whatever. Let's just use these. You know what? Fuck it. We're doing this the old-fashioned way. Indeed they should not. The light should indeed not be out. Then why are they out, I wonder? I don't know. Why don't you come on and check? Alright. But this is where the part begins, where I could have used the fracture leads.
Satellite shows you've reached Zerkheizi's building. County Clerk's office has construction permits on file for the floors below the penthouse and in the neighboring structure.
Any plans or blueprints on file?
I'll have Grim look into it. With this blackout.
I understand. I'll see if I can dig up some plans down here.
Good idea.
Right then. Not really. Lights are just fine.
Fisher, that's a hired gun if I've ever seen one.
He's no night watchman either. He's a merc. He's got the same kit as the guys who were protecting Lacerda.
This whole situation is getting uglier by the second. See if you can find out who these characters work for.
Will do.
Characters. Alright then. Oh, that's how you access the sniper mode. With the alt key. I see, that's interesting. That's really interesting. But yeah, I want to get the sticky shocker instead. Alright. Are we done? Cool.
What's going on here?
Good question. What is going on there? Come on, find out. quick. I did this as a means of preparation for action, so that I could flank those guys when required. What about that guy there? Nobody noticed me? I guess not. I guess he's still sleeping. Come on. You can kill him. Good. it took a while. I'll need to grab somebody to interrogate though, which is the biggest issue here. Okay, accessing the data on this. Okay, this is my result.
Work permits, architectural plans. Interesting. Zerkheizi has a hardened panic room off of his bedroom.
I'll check it out.
Looks like he also filed plans for construction in the next building over.
The next building?
I'm no architect, but if I'm reading these plans right, both buildings are connected across a rooftop. I'll leave the relevant data on your offset. Should help you navigate.
Thanks.
Fisher, Zerkheizi's cameras project an infrared beam so they can see in the dark.
If it's an infrared beam, I can see it in my night vision.
Exactly. And listen, it would help us keep tabs on Zerkheizi if we could use these cameras against him.
Gotcha. I'll try and run some taps.
Good work, Fisher. That's one camera tapped. There should be five more.
I'll keep my eyes open.
Absolutely. Now, with that being done, let's go ahead and start our assault then. I'm just gonna go ahead and reload this.
Fisher, looks like Zerkheizi has his own alarm system. Careful.
Nobody coming here? Come here. No? Okay. If you wish. But things to be that way.
The lights! Damn!
Come on then.
Are you trying to play with me? I can take it.
Not really. I just want to kill you is all. Am I done? No, I'm done now. Takes a while. It all takes a while really. I'm gonna try getting up there. See if it's even possible to get up there. Seems to not be the case. I mean, Fisher can't jump that high. Yeah, all it does is...
I'm serious, Sam. Too many alarms and these mercenaries will be after you.
Well, that's what I'm sort of hoping for. You know what? Let's just enter this crawl space and flank that guy. Even though he said man down, he still didn't do anything about the man down. That guy's down.
I saw something there.
Another guy down. We do have like a... health kit right in there, which we can use. And Samson. Cool. Let's try to avoid the next alarm. Because why not? Or maybe we can just walk into it. I mean, I don't exactly want to try to actively get alarms, but at the same time...
Good work, Fisher. That's 4 of 6 cameras tapped.
I'll keep an eye out for the other two.
Sam didn't get spammy again. Let's, take that camera out, which did not work out, for whatever reason. You know, I thought it would have worked out, but apparently it did not.
That pretty much confirms it. These records show Zerkheizi has a long history of transactions with the MCAS bank in Panama.
Is he the one who shipped the arms to Lacerda's goons?
It doesn't matter much now. We'll need to bring him in for a chat either way.
All right.
That is true. Like, these levels are designed with stealth in mind.
Gotcha.
Who?
Dvorak.
Where is he?
According to this, he's in the building next door. You can get there across the rooftop through the magnetically locked doors.
How do I get through the doors?
They're not magnetically locked anymore.
Thanks for that.
Right. Now we need to interrogate that one guy to figure out what Lacerda is after. Whoops, who's actually controlling them?
How long have you known him?
A long time. Since before this place. Since before Bosnia.
Before Bosnia? Good lord. I knew he had connections, but...
Yep. Normal.
This place? That's Doug Shetland's company.
I know.
Fisher, if Shetland turns out to be crooked...
If Shetland is crooked, I'll take him down myself. But I have a feeling there's more to it than that.
Could be. See if you can find out who's in charge of this protection detail. Maybe someone inside this place is playing both sides.
You got it.
Well, not exactly. It's like, yet someone inside this place is playing both sides, but both sides aren't what you think they are. Come here.
Why are these lights on?
Well, that did not work out in my favor. I was not hoping for things to go that way, but oh well. I guess that objective is wasted, unless we can grab somebody else to interrogate. Wish I could interrogate this guy, but I cannot, for whatever reason. Alright then, let's take the shortcut. Don't know why quick save there. There's literally no call to be quick saving over there. So typically, I think in some console version, you can actually enter through there. Those open windows there. But not in the PC version. So, one of the issues with the third person mod is that you don't know where you're going. What just happened? Yeah, maybe I could grab this guy instead. Now, if this wasn't realistic, there would be two more people up there. Sort of makes you glad that this isn't unrealistic. Come with me. We need to interrogate you. If you know anything.
What are you doing out here all by yourself?
Huh? Guarding the roof.
From what?
Let me go and I'll show you.
Actually, I meant to kill him, but oh well. Reflexes kicked in. He's dead. What I plan on doing is just taking the lights out for starters. Now this playthrough, I sort of want to keep it natural to where, you know, we don't exactly go out of our way to make ends meet, and in that effect, to that effect, I'm just gonna let that part go where I had to, you know, more or less.
Who killed the lights?
Good question. Who did kill the lights? Indeed. Nobody there. Could be somebody up here though.
Guess I'm a little jumpy.
Well, you might just be a little jumpy.
Forget it.
Indeed.
I don't want to find anything anyway.
I was sort of hoping you would stand near the thing there.
Nothing.
The wall mine, so that I could blow you up. I'll go ahead and do that. Once you get back over there and stand at your position. Go on then. That's always funny to me. And that eliminates everybody here. Do I want to hack the camera or do I want to use the vents to go inside? I wonder. You know what? Let's just hack the keypad. Right. 191 and 20. It's definitely 66, but it's also 10. Right then. So, this guy right here is a scientist that has been hired by, well, I don't know who, most likely Shetland or whatever, and I'm gonna try knocking him out.
Fisher, what the hell are you doing?
Sorry, I thought he was the enemy.
He seemed harmless enough. Now you're on your own in there.
Yep. Now, good thing is I actually know how to do this, so... So, I made sort of a comment the last few playthroughs. Where is it? Ah, right here.
Fisher, what are you doing?
I've seen these things before. This is a finite state machine.
It is?
Yeah. Looks like Dvorak is just the encoded innards of a 50-year-old scrap heap.
No wonder I couldn't hack into it.
It doesn't even speak the same language. I'm going to try and reinitialize the machine and retrieve an output stack for analysis.
Gotcha.
So yeah, I was talking about how infinite state machines are essentially commonplace and how Grim gets all excited about it, like she will right now.
Alright, I got the stack.
Fisher, judging by what we just saw, I think that's an infinite state machine, not a finite state machine.
What's the difference?
This one is self-referential. Each output stack is a logical instruction set that tells the machine to recurse itself and derive a more accurate set of instructions for the next execution cycle.
Fascinating. Can I go now?
Good work, Fisher. Time to make yourself scarce. Get to your primary extraction point.
On my way.
I did get all cameras, right? Ghouls. Tap the penthouse video cameras. I apparently missed one. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that then. Let's find the camera that we missed. I don't recall which camera it could be though. Oh, right. The one upstairs. I never actually tapped it. Oh well. So yeah, the previous time around, in my last two playthroughs, I was talking about how infinite state machines are everywhere, but actually they're not. I sort of had my computational theory mixed up, and well, infinite state machines are indeed something to be super excited about, because well, what we use every day are essentially finite state machines. They are not infinite state machines, and an infinite state machine, like the name suggests, essentially can have an infinite amount of states. Finite state machines only have two, true or false. So maybe with quantum computing, we might get an infinite state machine someday, pretty soon, but for now we don't have any.
Good work on the cameras, Sam. We'll have guys watching Zerkheizi 24/7.
Always happy to keep the donut dippers busy.
Right, so... Yeah, that... Just wanted to correct what I had said before. And this is our extraction. I don't know how it works, but that is our extraction. The elevator inside and a damn lift. That's our extraction. So discover who's in charge of the Zerkheizi protection detail is something that we could not complete. It was a secondary objective, but instead of grabbing that guy, I accidentally turned the lights off. And yeah, could not interrogate that guy. Tried interrogating somebody else, but did not work out in our favor. That being said, yeah, two bodies found, 12 enemies killed, and 3 knocked out. We left more people than we had previously. 35% success rating. Could have been lower, but then again, I'm not sure exactly trying to get it lower. But what we found out essentially is that the space is somehow involved in all this. We were supposed to find out that Milos Novak is actually Milan Nedic is involved in all of this. But yeah, so like I said, I sort of eliminated the people who would have known that. And yeah, I just decided to keep the natural flow of things instead of trying to make ends meet instead. So yeah, that's what we end up with. If we had interrogated that guy, we would have found out that it was actually Milan Nedic, or also known as Milos Novak, or the Barber of Bosnia, who is essentially handling these operations. But the truth of the matter is that it's not actually Milan Nedic. It's not actually Milos Novak. He's just working for Shetland, who's, you know, put him there as a means of insulation. Sam even goes ahead and confronts Shetland about it, trusting his friend, no doubt. But yeah, so Shetland comes over all the way to Hokkaido just to eliminate Nedic and Zerkheizi, because the spy agencies are getting too close to him. Unbeknownst to him, though, well, the NSA sees it all happening. But yeah, that's a concern for a later video. So that was that for Mission Penthouse. Next time we come back, the fingers are right now pointing at Displace. So the NSA is going to chase down Displace, enter Displace, try and figure out what's going on. The next mission, though, is going to be a little difficult because it's, well, it's one of those missions where we can't exactly kill anybody. So yeah, we're going to have to rely on the old school methods of knocking people out instead. It'll be interesting to see how that goes. That being said, thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for sticking around until the end. Until next time when we come back to Displace International. Take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.